Why we use SSR or solid state relay? Let's see a scenario where we have a tank filled with some liquid. The task here is to heat the liquid inside the tank up to 95 degrees Celsius. A thermocouple is installed in the tank to monitor the temperature of the liquid inside the tank. A heater is installed in the tank to heat up the liquid in the tank. We can monitor and control the temperature of the tank with the temperature controller. If we connect a thermocouple with a temperature controller, it starts to display the current temperature on the display. We cannot connect heater directly to the temperature controller. To turn on and off the heater, we need some switching device. We can use a relay or a contactor to switch on off heater. Relay normal open contacts can be used to switch on and off heater. Relay's normal open contact will be connected in series with heater and voltage source. Relay coil will be connected to the temperature controller. Now the temperature controller can turn on relay and relay contacts closes to apply voltage to the heater. But there is a problem with these relay contacts. Every time this relay contact makes or breaks, it creates a spark. Over the period of the time, the contacts of the relay get burnt and damaged. In some cases, because of the sparks between the contacts, these contacts can get welded together and continuous voltage applied to the heater causing overtemperature in the tank, and the temperature controller can no longer have control over the temperature. So the relays are not suitable for switching of the heaters and heavy inductive loads. To overcome these problems, we can use SSR or solid state relay. SSR relay don't have any moving parts in it. It uses a trike to switch on and off the AC load. Now let's see an example where we can understand how does SSR relay switch on and switch off AC loads. In this example, SSR relay is used to switch on and switch off a bulb. When a control signal is applied at the input of the terminals of the SSR relay, AC voltage will be applied to the bulb via power terminals of the SSR relay, terminal 1 and terminal 2. The power terminals of the SSR relay don't have any moving contacts inside it. Instead, it has a trike which allows the current to pass through the SSR relay. Coming back to our tank heating example. Here we can replace the electromechanical relay with the solid state relay. As the temperature controller applies the control signals at the input of the SSR relay, SSR relay trike starts to conduct electric current through the terminals 1 and terminal 2. And heater turns on and temperature in the tank gradually rises. As the temperature reaches the set point 95 degrees, the SSR relay stops conducting the current. In this way, the temperature controller can regulate the temperature in the tank. Now we can conclude today's tutorial by comparing electromechanical relay with the SSR relay. First, the movable parts. Electromagnetic relay have movable contacts, which make its life shorter. Because after some times, its contacts worn out and stop conducting the current. While in the SSR relay, we don't face such issues as there are no moving parts inside it and trikes or the transistor acting as a switching contacts. Lifetime of the solid state relay is fairly larger than the electromagnetic relay. If installed as per load amperage, switching speed of the relay is the time required to close the contacts inside the relay. SSR relay switching time can be as short as 1 millisecond, while the switching time of electromagnetic relay can lie between 20 milliseconds to 30 milliseconds. So, the SSR relay is more suitable for fast switching applications. Electromagnetic relay normally comes with multiple number of potential free contacts. This makes electromagnetic relay more flexible and adaptable in the machine operation. This means that we have plenty of the spare contacts in the electromagnetic relay
to turn on or off multiple field devices operating at different voltage levels with a single relay. In current carrying or load capacity, nowadays SSR is more preferable. It can go up to 50 amperes, while electromagnetic relay with movable contacts can only go up to 10 amperes. Arcing problem is normally related to electromagnetic relay because the movable contacts in it makes and breaks a circuit, which causes spark every time the contacts make or breaks. This problem is more noticeable when the relay is used to drive inductive loads like motors and solenoid coils. Both SSR and electromagnetic relays can switch AC and DC loads. In electromagnetic relay, we have potential free contacts, so we can switch AC and DC easily. SSR relay comes with transistor or trike acting as a switching element in it. Trike is used to switch on and off AC loads, while transistor can switch DC loads. That's the end of the today's learning session. I hope you like it. Please subscribe to my channel and stay connected for more amazing upcoming videos. Till next video, take care and goodbye.